The legendary actor Amitabh Bachchan has turned 80 today. An actor who was once rejected from All India Radio because of his baritone voice has been successfully proving his acting mettle even several decades later. He had announced his arrival for the first time when producer-director Prakash Mehra's film Zanjeer hit the screens in 1973. Zanjeer, when released, went on to become a box office blockbuster and established him as a star. He was given the title of the Angry Young Man by the media due to his performance in the movie. But the film's journey to the silver screen was not easy because there were no takers for the film. The producer had to make compromises and sell it to the Bombay Circuit distributor at Rs 4 lakh on outright basis, which meant if the film worked, the distributor kept it all. He had featured in a couple of successful films after a lineup of flops. Anand was one, but it was a Rajesh Khanna film. Bombay to Goa, but it was a film of Mehmood, the legendary comedian. Abhiman followed the success of Zanjeer, but it was still a Jaya Bhaduri film. So far, all he had to his credit was Saath Hindustani and a bit role in Sunil Dutt's Reshma aur Shera. However, the films that followed, Sholay and Deewar, cemented his place. Despite Zanjeer, the reigning superstar that time was still Rajesh Khanna. That was still Namak Haram released. In this movie, he played the role of a benevolent friend, but at the end of the movie, he got to put his newly acquired angry young man image on display and it became his film. It was an author-backed role for him. And with this, the era of Chocolatey Boy and Romance King Rajesh Khanna was over. Films like Dost, Roti Kapda Aur Makan, Kasauti and Majboor kept consolidating his place. The audience had accepted him. The year 1975 accounted for three Bachchan hits in Deewar, Chupke Chupke and Sholay. Amitabh Bachchan was given various titles like Megastar, The One Horse Race and even further a one-man industry. The entire nation had prayed for him when in 1982 he met with an accident while shooting for Manmohan Desai's film Kuli and was on deathbed. All of India was praying for him when he was lying unconscious, fighting with his seemingly inevitable death. He emerged from his injury with a status bigger than ever before. He was the people's man, not because of his films, but as an individual. Years down the line, when his venture ABCL failed and he somehow managed to avoid bankruptcy, his another phase began. This new phase took off with the television show Kaun Banega Crorepati, followed by a flood of offers for films and endorsements. He adjusted to working with the new and younger generation and it did not seem to matter whether the film had commercial potential. The films he started doing then were totally in contrast to the films which made him the megastar in 1970 and 80s. And to this day, the choices of his movies have been electric and wide-ranging. Actors, entertainers who go on for the marathon years are bestowed to a nation once in a generation. You're not